Good morning, everyone. Today is Thursday, October the 12th, 2023. I hope y'all are having a wonderful morning so far. And I'm back with another video. And before I start this video, I want to thank God for giving me the enlightenment, the understanding, and trusting me to make this video, to get this message out. I'm going in a different direction with this video than what I intended on doing. My first intention was, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on in the world right now, and the believers, well, I'm a believer of God, but the believer of the Bible, and I was a person that thought the Bible was tampered with, that is not really truly the complete word of God, right? So my intention with this video at first was to prove there's a lot of people going around saying that we're living in the last days right now, right? Because a lot of stuff is going on. So they're saying, you know, we're living in the last days. The Bible said we're living in the last days. So my intention was to go do some research to prove that they're wrong, that we're not living in the last days, and that they're crazy, right? That was my intention. That's what this video was gonna be about. That the people that are saying we live in the last days, they don't know what they're talking about. Stuff that's going on, blah, 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 has been going on. That's what I was going to do. But God had other plans. So I did some research before to prove them wrong. I was gonna have my facts in order to be able to show them facts that they wrong about we living in the last days right now. And by me doing my research, I found out that they were right. We are living in the last days. And when you say last days, we're not talking about like the last 7 days. You know, we got 7 more days left. We don't know how many days we got left actually before God come tear this thing down. The last days, they say like a day to God is like 1,000,000 years. So our days are not based on God's days. So the last days don't mean it's gonna be like it's only gonna last a week and then everything over with. It can go a period of 100 days or 100 years. Hold on, y'all. And according to the research that I just did, it tells me when the last days began, when the countdown started. And mankind entered into the last days at the beginning of World War I. According to the Bible chronological, the timetable of what I researched and what I found out, World War I began the beginning of the last days. That's when we entered the countdown. The clock started ticking, the beginning of World War I, from what I researched and what I found out. So I had to write, I came upon so much stuff that I had to write it down. So I'm gonna be reading so I won't forget, and then I'm gonna give you my take on what I read and what I wrote. So I had to take notes now, cause it's a lot of stuff. Y'all hold on a minute, I'm gonna hold on. Yeah, so according to the Bible, the disciples asked Jesus, how will we know when the last days are here? So, and this is what, according to the Bible, Jesus told the disciples. He said, you will have large scale war. You know, the wars and rumors of wars thing. And I was like, well, that's been going on. We've been having, you know, in my bright thinking, to prove them wrong, that's a lie. I was like, well, we've been had wars. But it said large scale wars. That means wars like everywhere. You got Ukraine and Russia going on right now. Hamas just attacked Israel going on right now. You got other nations threatening the war going on right now. Wars and rumors of wars. You got wars going on, large scale wars, along with other nations threatening to war. So there go your wars and your rumors of wars, all at the same time. He said it would all be going on at the same time. Yes, we've always had wars, but this is going on simultaneously at the same time. Okay. Famine and food shortages. Well, we've always had famine and food shortages in the world, but not like this. In America, I don't know if it's still going on, but for a long time, they didn't have baby food, formula. In America, no baby formula. I was like, man, that's weird. Something don't make sense with that. Now I'm seeing what was going on. Prophecy being fulfilled. Y'all remember, I don't know where you from if that happened, but in America we had, and it might still be going on, I don't have a baby, so I don't know. We had a formula shortage where they make it by the tons, and we ain't have none. Formulas to feed babies. I like Kraft blue plate, not Kraft, but blue plate sandwich bread on my bologna sandwiches. I make a tuna fish with it. I don't know if any of y'all know ever heard of blue plate, but they got a sandwich bread that I love. It was a shortage of it. I couldn't buy it no more. I'm like, where's the blue plate? Looked up online. It was some type of thing where they didn't have the supplies, and they couldn't get the supplies to make the stuff. They couldn't make the sandwich bread. There's a lot of more foods that once were on the shelves are not on the shelves anymore. And people, you probably haven't noticed or paying attention to it, so you ain't thought about it, like, where did that go? But by me liking this particular brand of sandwich bread and them not having the ingredients to make it, I'm like, well, damn. Not too long ago, we didn't have chicken wings. In America, I ain't talking about no third world country where it's always been food shortages. I'm talking about America, the land of plenty. We didn't have chicken wings. And probably still don't. And that's why the price of food so high. Because it's a shortage. But the media and the news is not really reporting that because they don't want people to panic. But we're going through a food shortage right now. Another sign of the last days that I didn't think about until I called myself trying to prove the people that said we're living in the last days. I'm studying to prove them wrong and end up now I got to prove them right because they was right. And here we go. Earthquakes. Now all these things what I'm naming to y'all is stuff that Jesus told his disciples according to the Bible. Earthquakes. Before we always had earthquakes. Not like we have them now. Not at the large scale we have them now. Back to back. All over the world. Not just one little country in Hawaii somewhere. Everywhere. Earthquakes. Y'all see the news. Every time you look around, an earthquake can hit somewhere. Big earthquakes. Tearing up stuff. An earthquake caused a tsunami not too long ago. And I don't mean earthquake that just happened like 2 weeks ago. The last days is in a period of time, not like I said, starting in 1914. I don't mean within the last 3 days of earthquake we had. I mean over this period of time from 1914 up until now, how many earthquakes we've been having. It ain't never been like that. So, earthquakes, more than ever. Disease and epidemics, which we've always had, not like this. the biggest example, COVID. But COVID been around since I've been, I'm in my 50s. We ain't never had nothing like this. COVID, the whole world shut down. And it's not gone, it's still here. And there's more to come. Pay attention, there's more to come. Epidemics. We had the Spanish flu. We had, remember what I just told you at the beginning, we ain't talking about what just happened over the last 5-10 years. The last day of the whole period is from 1914 until now. We've had all types of epidemics in that time frame. Epidemics, pandemics, diseases, chickenpox, yellow fever, all types of stuff, Ebola. In a period of time, not just over the last 2 weeks now. We're talking about from 1914, according to when it started, until now. Now, we're dealing with COVID, but we've dealt with all kinds of other pandemics and epidemics before COVID in this time period. So, diseases and epidemics, that's another sign of the last day. Crime. My God, do I need to say anything about crime? Yes, crime has been around since the beginning of time, but not like now. Cities that were once good places to live, you've always had places where there was crime. New York, Chicago, Compton, California. You know, you got places that crime been there. Now you got crime, major crime in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Go look up the crime in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Go look up the crime in Portland, Oregon. Portland, Oregon? They got a drug infestation. Fentanyl, not like fentanyl, whatever you call that stuff. It's going crazy in Portland, Oregon. Places you ain't never had high crime before. It's overridden with crime. Place that you would normally move to get away from the crime, it's there too. Crime has spread rapidly. Everywhere, there ain't no safe place no more. Ain't no safe places. Even if you got money, can move out, you still ain't safe. They kicking in doors of millionaires, places that you once weren't able to get to. They ain't safe no more. They can't hide. Another is ruining of the earth. That's in Revelation 11 and 18. Or climate change. How we destroying the earth. Man is destroying the earth. Ruining of the earth. This was written in Revelation 11th chapter, verse 18, way back before we had all this stuff going on with the earth now. All the pollution, the air, the water, the food. We having to clone vegetables, fruit and vegetables. People talking about they thinking that they're eating healthy because they're eating fruits and vegetables, but really you're not, because the seeds they're making the fruits and vegetables with are made in the lab. Already with the pesticides in the seeds, so they won't have to spray the plants to save money. So you eating poison when you eating fruits and vegetables because the seeds that they're using are made by Monsanto. They're called GMOs, genetically modified organisms. We're living in the last days. This one. Deteriorating attitudes, which is describing people nowadays. If you look around, if you know how people are nowadays, observe people. And so many people are ungrateful, disloyal, your friends turning on you, your best friends, people that you thought would love you, disloyal, turn their back on you, stab you in the back. People don't want to come to no agreement, from the politician on down to family members. We can't get along. Politicians can't agree on nothing, even though they know what's right, they can't agree on it. No agreement on anything. People disagree with you about 2 + 2 = 4, they're going to disagree with you. And you know it. Slanderers. People lying on people like it's okay. I get online, get on the internet, say anything about somebody, knowing it ain't true, they have to come back and apologize. get sued about it, you know, pay off the little lawsuit, but they done made a lot of money off lying on somebody. Tasha K lying on Cardi B, talking about she had herpes or whatever. Slanderers, just say anything about anybody. Just say whatever you want to say. People say anything about you. Some people said I was gay. I ain't gay, whatever. People will say anything about you. Slander. Y'all know you got people saying something about you ain't true. People you don't even know lying on you. Calling your name, saying stuff behind your back that ain't true. Slanderers. People ain't got no self-control. Do any and everything they want to do. Drink till they pass out. Drug till they pass out. No self-control whatsoever. Eat till they 800 pounds. Make a TV show about it. Make a TV show about being 800 pounds. My 600 pound life. Y'all know what I'm talking about. No self-control. Fierce. I'm talking about will cut your head off. Kill babies. They don't care. Women and children, once upon a time, women and children were off limits when it comes to gun battles and stuff. They kill women and kids, anything. Fierce. No love for God, for good. No love for good. Somebody claiming to be good, trying to do the right thing, they hate you. Look at you. You get a two-shoe. You think you better than everybody else. Nobody want to hear all that. People can do whatever they want to do. You see women half naked. I say something about it. Look at you. Just a hater. She's showing pride in herself. Self-love. All that. You know, no love for good. Whatever good is bad now. Good is bad now. Good ain't in. You think you're better than everybody else. Full of pride. All you see is people on social media, selfies. Look at me, look how beautiful I am. Selfies. I'm beautiful, I'm gorgeous. Look at me, look at my outfit. Look at my cars. Look at my house. Look at my job. I just got a promotion. I just bought 2 new houses. I'm in the real estate. Holler at me. Pride. Breakdown of the family. Breakdown of the family. The family is over. There are no families. No fathers in the house. Mother, if a father trying to be involved with the child, the mother won't let the father be involved. He ain't paying the child support. The family element is gone. Families don't love each other no more. Families out here killing each other. Family against brother killing brother. Sister, I just seen an article where a sister just stabbed her sister, killed her. Families ain't getting along. My family's a tight-knit family. Lately, we've been having conflict that we're trying to work through. A family that ain't never had no issues. We love each other. We close-knit. Satanic forces have come against my family. I know something wrong. When I saw that, I knew something was wrong. My family don't bicker amongst each other. We get together, we love on each other. So I know something going on, say, spiritually. So the family breakdown is evident. You see it. No love for God. You mention God nowadays, people look at you like you cussed them out. God. Ain't no God. I don't believe in no God. You think all this stuff that popped up out of nowhere. The grass, the earth, your ass. It just randomly happened. Religious hypocrisy. People claiming and appearing to worship God, but they don't live by it. 2 Timothy 3 and 5. This is what Jesus said. Religious hypocrisy. People that appear to worship God, but they don't live by it. That's one of the reasons I don't go to church and I don't be around religious people now. Because all the people that I know talking about the Lord, they Lord and Savior, they love God, they worshiping God, they're going to church every Sunday, and be worse than the people that don't believe in God. They live in a lifestyle worse than the people that don't believe in God. You got atheists that's living better and doing better and treat you better the people that claim to be children of God. Religious hypocrisy. I can go on forever about that one. Pastors got babies outside the marriage. The pastor, he riding Rolls Royces while his congregation struggling. Everybody sleeping with everybody in the church. Every sin in the Bible they in there doing. And then want to come out and preach to somebody, and we looking at you not living by the word you preaching. You turning people away from God. God ain't pleased with that. You turning people away from God instead of bringing people to God, because we looking at your lifestyle with your religious hypocrisy. Right here, I look at all this. And last but not least, with all the evidence that's going on around us right now, including myself, I ignore it. All the evidence that's showing us something ain't right. Something is going on. Look how fast, like now, time has speeded. Have you noticed how fast time has speeded up? Time moving like that now. It's moving. Time is speeding up. Pay attention. We were just saying Happy New Year. Seemed like yesterday. It was just 2020 when COVID hit and the shutdown. It's 2023 now. It seemed like the shutdown was just yesterday. 2020. COVID hit in 2020 and they shut the world down. It's 2023. It's going to be 24. That 4 years gone like that. We were just saying Happy New Year. Now we're going to be saying Merry Christmas again. Like that. Time has speeded up. And we're ignoring this. We're ignoring it. So that's the last but not least, people would ignore the evidence. It ain't real. It ain't true. You're lying. You're crazy. That was me. So I'm going to end this video by saying, yes, we are living in the last days. I got to go do a little more looking into the Bible for what I thought was not true or not the word of God. And I could be wrong. As a matter of fact, I am wrong. You don't got to believe me, but I'm bringing you this message for a reason. Don't be hearers of the word, be doers of the word. We're being warned right now, include me. What am I going to do? I don't know. But I set out to prove the Bible wrong. I set out to prove that these so-called prophecies were wrong. And I ended up being proved wrong in my research. So I had to go in a different direction with this video. I hope y'all watch it to the end. And look it up yourself. Y'all have a blessed day.